So identification of metamorphic rocks. In this, I told you already there are two types. One is foliated, one is non-foliated. So actually this is non-foliated. Quartzite and hornfels are massive rocks. Okay, and the schist, gneiss, slate, phyllite, these all comes under foliated rocks. And this limestone, this is also massive rocks, sometimes inorganic. Okay, so unfoliated rocks, foliated rocks. So schist, gneiss, slate and phyllite are this is with foliation, that means layered rocks. Okay, normally these are fine grained and these are coarse grained in general. Okay, yeah, so this is under metamorphic classification of rocks. So this specimen, what you are seeing, rock specimen, is a slate. See, actually slate is a layered rock. Now this is little bit compact, but normally the slate will be layered. Now you cannot see here layers, but it will be layered rock. Okay, so this slate is layered rock. When you are small, when you are writing the first time, when you are writing on the slate, that's nothing but it's just a slate rock. Okay, so when you see the slate will be like this, and it is a layered rock and it is foliated and it is fine grained, so you cannot see any grains here. So this, if you see here, can you see any grains? No. So this is a fine grain. Then shale to slate under heat and pressure. So heat is predominant. So shale is a sedimentary rock, slate is a metamorphic rock. So from shale to slate, this is formed. So what are the importance? It is melanocratic, means dark color. Then it is gravity is medium, structure is foliated, fine grained. Minerals present are mica, chlorite, quartz, feldspar, oxides of iron. The name of the rock is slate. Origin and occurrence, metamorphic, shale to slate under metamorphism. So uses floor and roofing purpose. So when you see the slate under a microscope, interlocking crystals parallel to each other, fine low grade metamorphic rock. So this is a slate, when you see under a microscope, actually it is not that much clear, but it will be very dark in this one. You got my point? So it looks very dark actually. So this is slate. This one, what you are seeing is gneiss. So normally if you see this rock, you can see one dark layer, one light layer, one again one dark band, one light band, again one dark band. So you can see the bands. So this is the specialty of gneiss. So it will look like granite, but it is not a granite. In granite, these bands will not be there. But in gneiss, these bands will be there. This is called gneissic bands. So here if you see, what I have shown, this is dark band and this is light band. The dark band is made up of mafic minerals, that means iron and magnesium will be more. In the light bands, what you have seen, that is felsic minerals, that is silica. So if you see here, this dark bands is iron and magnesium, and this light bands is mostly silica. Dark band and light band, this is dark band again. So this dark band and light band make you this one. One more rock is there, that is hornblende gneiss. So hornblende is dominant. So how the gneiss is formed? Gneiss is formed from schist to gneiss under regional metamorphism, that means heat and pressure. So what are the, so gneiss is like this. So if you see here, this rock is gneiss. You can see here gneiss nicely. So this is a gneiss rock. You can see this slightly bands like this. So this is gneiss rock. Okay. So if you see here, so this is hornblende gneiss. So what are the properties? Leucocratic, high specific gravity, gneissose structure. So this structure is called gneissose. Dark band, light band, dark band, light band, dark band, light band. Then texture is coarse grained. You can see clearly the minerals. So this is called coarse grained. So minerals present is felsic minerals and mafic minerals. So felsic minerals are like feldspar and quartz, and mafic minerals, I told you, which are mostly of iron and magnesium, are amphibole, pyroxene group, dark bands. So name of the rock is hornblende gneiss. So normally origin is metamorphic, used as road metal and building stone, because this is it has the properties of granite. So this is the best rock for your civil engineering purpose. And when you see under the microscope, you can see the biotite, you can see the dark patches or garnet. Same garnet can be seen in PPL, plain polarized, and cross Nicols. Same dark bands will be, dark spots are there. This is called garnet. So if I will show you, just watch it. Just I have seen already also, but again, if you want, you see this one. So this is what you are seeing here is the garnet selenite gneiss. Okay. So the drawn patch is nothing but biotite mica. Okay. So this is marble. You can see this. You can clearly identify what is a marble. So this is mostly used for your flooring purpose. So what is the meaning of marble? It is formed from the mineral. What mineral? Marble. This is formed from limestone. So limestone is a sedimentary rock, marble is a metamorphic rock. So from limestone, marble is formed. You got it? So this is under heat predominant. Heat is predominant. So this is under metamorphism. So here, this is sedimentary rock and this is metamorphic rock. Now you got it? Yeah? So this is a marble. So there will be colors in the marble, sometimes little bit difference. And what is the marble, if this is made up of calcium carbonate, CaCO3 plus other minerals. So this normally, if you see here, this knife, what I am showing you, the knife. So this knife is 5.5, okay, and your marble is 3.6. So when I scratch on the marble, it will easily make a scratch. So that means this is 5 and this is 3. This is less than the, so if I scratch here also, it can be easily scratched because this hardness is 3. Okay, so leucocratic, it is leucocratic, high specific gravity, non-foliated. So this is under non-foliated rock. So there is no foliation, only it is a compact massive rock. Okay, so this is massive. Then minerals presence is calcite with other accessory minerals. Name of the rock is marble. So normally limestone to marble under metamorphism. Then it is used as a building stone. Okay, fine grain. So heat is predominant and it comes under contact and thermal metamorphism. Limestone is changing to marble. Understood everybody? Yeah. So this rock what you are seeing is a chloride cyst. See, in the talc cyst, talc is dominant. Okay, see here, if you see the talc cyst, talc is dominant. But in the chloride cyst, chlorite is dominant. Okay, so I already have shown you in the thing section in the mineral. So you can see here, almost, see these are the layers in the chloride. So this is green in color. So chloride means from the chlorine it has chlorophyll. So chloride cyst, green colored. It is a layered rock, foliated rock. Chloride mineral is predominant. And it is melanocratic, that means it is color. So melanocratic, somewhat dark in color. Medium specific gravity, foliated in schistose, coarse texture, then chloride cyst. It is a metamorphic rock. It is not suitable for civil engineering purpose. When you see, this is called schistose structure. You can see like this. Layered, so this is called schistose. Even in the microscope also, it will be like that. Okay? And this is under low-grade metamorphism. So this rock what you are seeing is talc cyst. Talc cyst. So cyst is a metamorphic rock in which talc is little bit more. So talc is dominant, so we call it as talc cyst. Okay? So this is talc cyst. So why? Because of the dominance of the cyst means you can see the layered rocks. You can see the layers. And this is talc. So how you can recognize what is the hardness of talc? It is 1. So it is less than your fingernail. So when I scratch with a fingernail, it can be easily scratched. So this indicates that this rock is a talc. So talc cyst. So leucocratic. Okay. And leuco to melanocratic, medium to heavy, foliated and schistose. This is also foliated rock. And coarse grain. Predominant talc is predominant, talc cyst, metamorphic rock, and it is not suitable for engineering purpose, but it is suitable for the economic purpose. Then it is a foliated type mineral predominant, hardness is 1, can scratch with a nail. Okay, yeah, this is talcist. So this rock what you are seeing is phyllite. See, this is a rock formed from shale to slate. See what is, see, I will show you the shale shale to slate and slate to phyllite. Okay, so this is phyllite. So from shale it is transforming to slate, slate to phyllite. Now if you see phyllite here, this is shiny. So most of the minerals are mica. So around 60 to 70% fine mica will be there. So and it is having perfect schistosity, and it is a lamellar form. Sorry, it is actually foliated rock. So you can see the layers. So the layers in the rock. So this is called foliated rock. So what is phyllite? Leucocratic, light color, medium, foliated, fine grain. You can see, you cannot see the grains actually here. This fine grain. Then muscovite, chlorite and quartz. Muscovite is maximum, almost you can see, because of the shining, and the chlorite will be there, quartz will be there. The name of the rock is phyllite. Origin and occurrence metamorphic, not suitable for civil engineering purpose. Because here, why it is not suitable? Because it is a layered rock and it is a weak rock. Okay, so mica predominant, shining property of the rock, foliated. So this rock what you are seeing is quartzite. So mostly the quartzite is mostly the quartzite is 90% of quartz, that is silica. See, this is a variety of quartzite in which little bit slight green in color due to some accessory minerals, but this is also quartzite, this is also quartzite. So the color may vary depending upon the accessory minerals. So quartzite is formed from the sandstone to quartzite by the regional metamorphism. Okay, here the heat will be predominant. So this quartzite is a metamorphic rock. Okay, and this comes under non-foliated rock. Okay, so quartzite is color is leucocratic, specific gravity is medium, non-foliated, texture is fine grain. You can see here, you cannot see any grains, it is fine grain. So this is fine grain, you cannot see any grains, this is fine grain. For example, if you see here, these are grains, you can see the grains, sizes are little bit, you can see the grains. But here if you see here, this is fine grain. So minerals present is, quartz is dominant, name of the rock quartzite, its origin is metamorphic, and its uses suitable for civil engineering purposes. So in this, silica is predominantly, okay, predominant, that means silica is more. Okay, so this is quartzite. So when you see the quartzite under microscope, see, if you see the thin section under PPL, for example, now you can see 90% quartz with other accessory minerals, and quartz normally exhibits wavy extension. You can see the small, very small size of quartz. Why? Because this has been metamorphosed from sandstone. So the it is a very fine texture. Okay, so when you see the same under a microscope, how it looks, you see. So this is the quartzite under the microscope. You can see here clearly. So this is quartzite under microscope. You can see the fine grains. See, you see, I am just making a rotation of the disc. So if you see here, I'll show you. So, just wait. See, if you see here clearly, so I am rotating the disc. If I am rotating the disc, you can see that all the color goes and comes. If you see here, the color will go and come. So this is called wavy extension in quartz. At one place you cannot see, that means the color will go and color will come. So this is under, this is quartz, it is fine grain, you can see the grains, fine. Okay, so this is quartz under, quartzite under microscope. This is plain cross phenicals. Okay,